Topographic maps include contours to depict the elevation and shape of the land, scale to depict a large area in a small space, and words and symbols to show complex information. But how are these maps used in the real world? There are many times an overview of an area is useful in everyday life. Key examples are recreation, resource management, and emergency management. Topographic maps can be used for planning outdoor activities, like multiple-day hikes. Part of the Duke of Edinburgh's award is a hike through remote landscapes. There are many possible journeys, and their successful completion relies on the use of topographic maps to plan the route. If you wanted to hike from coast to coast in the UK, Hadrian's Wall near England's border with Scotland provides a great opportunity. Using a topographic map, you can see that it is very hilly, but not very wooded, and the route doesn't run into too many rivers. It's also a long walk, 84 miles, not one you could complete in a day. A topographic map is essential for choosing a location to camp on this hike, finding water sources, and locating places to shelter in case of poor weather. Electricity can be produced either renewably or non-renewably. Non-renewable energy sources such as coal and uranium are mined. But infrastructure for renewable resources like wind and solar are built on the Earth's surface. In both cases, resource managers need topographic maps to decide where to dig or locate structures. If they're overlaid with the relevant information, using GIS, topographic maps can reveal coal and uranium deposits for mines, flat and sunny places for solar panels, and windy areas for wind farms. They can reveal other important features to consider. Mines need to be close to roads suitable for trucks to transport the coal or uranium. To minimize environmental disruption, they should also be placed where water and sediment flow do not cause damage. For example, the Adani Group's efforts to build the Carmichael coal mine in Queensland, Australia, became a controversial issue in 2019. While the area is rich in high-quality coal, it's also host to several endangered species, and runoff from the mine is highly likely to damage the nearby Great Barrier Reef. Care should also be taken to not desecrate places that First Nations or Indigenous people consider important. Moving away from a reliance on coal, countries like the US, the UK, and China are taking a cleaner approach and are investing in wind farms. Wind farms require a suitable landscape on a plateau. Locations must be at an altitude that will maximize wind speed and have land access points for construction and future maintenance purposes. Planning should also ideally take into account the proximity of population centers and housing. Natural disasters are difficult problems to plan for and manage. Forest fires can quickly destroy natural and built-up environments. Avalanches prove fatal to hikers. Floods leave homes ruined and people trapped. For emergency managers to plan to minimize hazards, avoid disasters, and rescue people, it's important they have access to detailed topographic maps. For example, topographic maps that detail flood zones show safe places to build new housing. But if people already live in these areas, topographic maps are vital to disaster management plans. These maps can show where the safe high ground is to weather out the flood, and even predict water movement direction. Next time you catch the news, think about how topographic maps might be helping people plan for the future, solve a problem, or deal with a disaster.
If you liked this video, you can find it and so many more at ClickView.net. Sign up for free today.